I'm Peter Zwilinski, and I would like to show you the process of slide redesign, which we use in infoDiagram. So I'd like to share my experience working with slides. And in infoDiagram, we help people with creating stunning presentations by providing them resources and tips how to create clear and attractive slides. And I would like to share the transition, the process of how you can use and how I would redesign the slide with a specific example today, which is the comparison table. So this is the source slides which we have, and we'd like to change this default looking table, which is not very attractive, and it's hard to see what's the most important here, to, for example, to design like this. Or there could be another design which you can try, is this kind of untypical comparison table. So let me show how this slide resilient design process can look like. If you want to jump directly to the slide redesign, then we would just take this table and let's make a copy of it. So Control D on this slide over here, make me copy of it. That will be my new slide. And as this is a table, if you want to just make it different, look different, the quickest way is just go to table design tab over here, and choose one of the styles which PowerPoint offers you. These styles are based on your color palette, so these colors are based on accents which are present in this specific template. So for example, I can choose the blue one, and as you can see, at least these typical styles, they remove the grid, which was not very nice, but they still look somehow typical. Working with the styles, you can check, decide if it has a header, your table has a header row or total row, so the colors adapt to what you have here. For example, you can turn on or off the banded rows or banded columns, depending what you want to underline. It's a good way to show that the lines should be read together. However, this is probably not the best way to start the slide redesign, because looking at the content of the slide, it's something else than it may seem on the first look, because this slide is telling us that we have a table with three columns, so it looks like comparison of three items. However, to make the proper slide redesign, we should start actually with a first step, which is the proper content analysis, to see what is actually slide about, and that will tell us what we should redesign, what kind of visual representation to choose. So going back to our source slide over here, I'm just going to copy it here. And let's make two copies. So to have it by hand, the source one, this is my new slide. So looking at the content of the slide, actually I see that this is comparison of not three items, but two items, traditional marketing and digital marketing. And this is just the benefit of this digital marketing. So this is actually crucial information that we should use in our design process. So the traditional marketing should be set. Let's use the one color which represents traditional marketing, and we can choose the color which represents something traditional. And usually the blue one is more traditional type. And digital marketing, let's use it. So these two columns, or this one, we can use some more digital, more modern color. Let's use the yellow or the orange one here. And this table is getting quite heavy. Like there, it's nice, it's colorful, but maybe it's too much colorful. So let's just lighten up these parts, so the details. And in order to keep the harmony of the colors, let's choose the same color, the color from the same source, so of the same type. And PowerPoint has 10 colors in the palette over here. So these 10 columns represent 10 colors which are present in the palette. And the column over here represents the lighter or darker color of the base color. So if you want to keep the same style of the color, the same hue, choose the the color from the same column. So here, let's repeat the process from the yellow, from the orange one here, let's use the lighter one. You could actually use the same also for the benefits, because the benefits are related to the digital marketing. So let's use the same way over here. Next thing which I would do, so we finished the, let's say, the content analysis and basic slide design. So at least we underline now that we have two types of comparison, two items which we compare. I would like to maybe show that third one is somehow related, but not directly the same. So we can use the bit darker color over here. However, I still would do something more over here, because this black grid doesn't represent very well. Like, it looks quite ugly and still it gets too much attention, the black grid, and also reminds me the old style of the tables like this without any design touches. So the quick thing what you could do is change the grid to either to remove it at all, and to remove it you go to table design and go to no border, or if you want to still keep the line, so it's like the border between the items, the things which we usually do is to add the white border, so white grid. And so for this one, you need to go to design tab, choose the colors first. So let's choose the white one or light gray and apply the borders. This way you have light separation of the items of the cells, but it's not overwhelming, it's just neat way how to edit. One more thing which I would do is to change the color of the text over here to white. The black is maybe too heavy, or this is still readable enough. And you can add a small design touch so it doesn't look as only table, to add a here little untypical arrow in the form of triangle. So I'm putting here the triangle, I'm rotating it 90 degrees. To have exactly 90 degrees, it's good to keep the shift key, and then the rotation will be like by certain jumps. So let's move it over here, and just good trick is to change this color of it to the same as this middle column. So it will kind of somehow nicely blend together. If you want to make the table more representative or easier to understand, it's good to represent the main categories, the key categories, by some graphics. We don't have place too much for some pictures, but we have maybe place for icons. And icons, where we would put the icons? We could put it over here or somewhere on the side, but I would suggest do this. So let's just put this one in two lines. And also, design suggestion would be to align text to the left, because text aligned to the center, it looks okay when you have one or two words, but once you have more words, like almost whole sentences, it's harder to read, because the beginning of each line is on different place. So let's just move all the text and align it to the left. This way it will be easier to read, faster to read, so you know where's the beginning of the line, and also will gain place for the icons over here. So we can represent these two categories, these two traditional and digital marketing by icons. And for the icons, sometimes it's hard to choose proper icon, and especially when you have this kind of abstract terms like marketing or what's traditional, what's the representation of traditional. That's why we add to our templates usually a set of icons which are related to the topic, so you can easily reuse them. And here I have some icon sets relates to these topics. So for example, we have people, communication, digital, business metaphors, IT devices. So for digital, let's choose, for example, these 01s as representation. Control C, so copy it. Control V is to paste it over here. We'll do recoloring in a second. And for the traditional one, we could use either the these pillars or paper. I would maybe choose this one with a loudspeaker as a, let's see, the traditional old way of speaking or communication. So let's put it over here. We can make it smaller. All our icons are vector shapes, so they are sharp, and you can edit the colors quite easily. These are outline icons, so you to change the color, you need to change the color of the outline, not the fill. So let's choose the white one, so they will not stand up too much, because the goal is actually the goal of the slide is to get attention firstly to the column, less to the icons. Icons are only additional graphics. And we have the slides ready. Eventually, if you want to move further or more beyond the table design, because with table design you can do some small things, but it's hard to, let's say, animate only the first column or add more untypical shapes. So in order to do this one, I would suggest you to redo the table, change it to shapes and text like we did here. And this way it takes a bit more time rewriting, but then it gives you more freedom to use the shapes, different untypical shapes. And for example, you can quite easily just group the shapes and add them different animation. So if you go to animation pane, I can add this kind of animation. So show column one by one, which would be harder in the table. So that's the design of this kind of slide. So we moved from source slide, we did content analysis, we did slide redesign and some beautification steps, and we've been able to create this kind of nice table. If you want to learn more and get more resources and tips about how to do the design, come to our website infodiagram.com. We have quite vast library of thousands of diagrams and icons which you can use, all are editable, and you can start with just signing up to our email tutorial and get the free graphics. So if you go to free sample, infodiagram.com/free sample, you sign up over there, you will receive a series of emails and extra free diagrams and icons from us. So thank you for listening and see you in our next video.